Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Todoist series. My name is Carl Pullein and this week it's all about filters. Now, last week I did a special edition episode of Todoist After Hours series, and in that series we talked about filters and some of the best filters you can use in Todoist. Well, according to my opinion. And that led me to thinking, well, maybe what I should do is do an episode on my favorite filters, the filters that I generally use, not necessarily every day, but do use them for my planning, for my workflow, and for able to just get back on top of things when things fall apart, because sometimes things fall apart. So that's what I'm going to show you today. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this episode, then please help me by clicking that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks and news on Todoist, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, I'm going to hand you over to my Todoist now and show you some of my favorite filters. Okay, so what we're going to do is go through a number of the filters that I use pretty much every day, plus some that I don't use but I think are really useful, particularly if you're using Todoist in many different ways. Now, first up, I'm going to show you my dashboard. Now, I did cover this in a recent episode, but since we've been able to use the sections feature, the forward slash feature, I've now brought something else into my dashboard because I just want to be reminded of it. And that's up here. I now have my this week's focus in my dashboard, which means that every single day when I open up Todoist, I get to see exactly what I have decided I'm going to focus on. Now that comes from my, if I just go into here, where are we? This isn't working very well. Let's close that a minute. And we go to my purpose and objectives here. So I have my purpose and objectives here, which is basically set up with sections, which is this week's focus, this week's objectives, this month's objectives, and this quarter's objectives. Now, this is really objectives. These are not necessary tasks that are coming up in my project view, my time sector view. These are just things that I want to get completed during this week, in this case, this month, and this quarter. Now, this one, for example, achieve a growth rate of 70% year on year based on third quarter 2019, for example. That's more of a goal, if you like. There's no actual task here. There's not much I can do on a day-to-day basis except be focused on sales in order to get that growth rate. Same here. Get body fat percentage down to 23%. That's just persistency. That's just making sure I'm not eating too much and I'm exercising at the right level. And also making a decision on whether to run Chun Chun Marathon this year. That's another one. It's not really a task. I suppose making a decision is a task, but these are just things to keep me aware. And I check this every Sunday when I do my weekly planning session, and I do a review of it every Wednesday evening just to see that I'm on target with all of these things. But this one here is something that changes every week, and it's something that I like to bring in. So in my dashboard view now, I do have this week's focus. Now, you're all going to be asking, what's the filter for this? Quite simple, really. If I edit my filter, all it is now is this week's focus. That's forward slash this week's focus. And it needs to be written in the same way as you have written it in your project folder. Then it's my P inbox. P is for project, so P inbox, comma, overdue, comma, and then today. So that's what's showing me there. Now, for some of you, you may want to add in there waiting for, if you have a waiting for label, for example, you could just put comma and then at waiting for, which will give you a waiting for items. So this is a dashboard view. This is what I see every time I hit the home button here, and every time I hit the H keyboard shortcut, that will give me this view. Now, for those of you who have followed me for any while, you know that my today's objectives, which is obviously completely out of sync because it should only be two, but these are my objectives, say, for today. That's just a really simple filter. That is just today and P1. So anything flagged as red, P1 flag, and today is going to come up in that list. Today's focus is all my other tasks that are flagged. And the reason I do this is because normally, on a day-to-day basis, I would have 10 tasks only in here. Now, 10 tasks are not overwhelming. If you have all your non-prioritized tasks in there, you can have like 20 tasks in. And it's not a great way to start the day to see a list of 20 things. It's actually quite demoralizing sometimes. So I really want to see only the things that I've decided are my objectives or my focus tasks, the things that I really want to get done today. And simple, that one is, well, is today and exclamation mark P4, which means not P4. Hopefully you're writing these down. And then we've got my focus 10 here. Now, my focus 10 is going to include anything today and anything tomorrow that's got a flag. Now, this is what I use for my planning sessions, daily planning sessions, because normally when I do my planning, these will have been completed and they will be. So if I just show you this, if I move this now to tomorrow's date, and I can move, say, this one to tomorrow's date, and I'll use this one to tomorrow's date. What you'll see is these are all coming up for tomorrow. So that means that when I go into this list, I have a very easy way of seeing anything that I didn't complete from my focus list today is still going to be in that list, and anything that is coming up tomorrow. And I do try to make sure that when I finished processing this at the end of the day, there is nothing left in for today and everything is for tomorrow, and there's no more than 10 tasks. This just keeps things nice and manageable. Again, the filter for that is 2 days and not P4, exclamation mark P4. Okay, so those are my ones. Those are the ones that I use every single day. Now, for those of you who are using the time sector system, maybe you want to have today's recurring areas of focus, and that one's a really nice one to have. So today's recurring areas of focus, when you're doing your planning session, you can see the tasks that you've decided are your most important tasks for today that's coming up in your recurring areas of focus. And the filter for that one is today and then / so we're using the sections icon here, the / recurring areas of focus, and that will come up nicely there. Now, next 5 days objectives essentially is anything that's going to come up in the next 5 days. So again, I can look at this on a Monday, and without, like, unlike seeing this in the upcoming view, so if I go in the upcoming view, this will show me everything, like as you can see here, everything that's also not flagged. And again, it can be quite as I would say, quite overwhelming when you look at that. So when you use this one, next 5 days objectives, it's only the ones that I flagged red that will come up, and that will tell me what my objectives are that I've decided are going to be for the next 5 days. So it's something that I would probably look at on a Monday. Again, you can say today's priorities. Oh, sorry, just to show you that one, the filter for that one is 5 days and P1. Now, of course, you can do 7 days and P1. You can do 3 days and P1, and just to change the number there. And you get the dates, the number of days that you want. Next one is today's priorities. I think I've done that one. Today's priorities. Yes, I've done that one. That's very much today's objectives. So that's another one that you can actually use. It's the same as today's objectives. It's just today and P1, but it's just another name for that one. I can also filter out any of my routines. Now, normally, routines do not come up with flags because they're just routines. But sometimes I may have missed a day, like in this case, maybe yesterday was raining. My dog really does not like going out in the rain. So then today, taking my dog out for a walk could be a priority. But normally my routines. Now, this is how to get things back to the full view, but you can do that now by using sections. So moving into this one here, next 3 days is a really good one to have. So I can have today, and it's going to show me tomorrow and Sunday. So I can just see all my tasks for the next 3 days if I wish. And that's just one that you can use. And again, the filter for this one, the routines, is because this is now using the sections. So if I just close that a minute, go into my routines folder, you can see that my routines is no longer subprojects, and I've created this as sections. So it's all in there and I can see all my sections. And as I pointed out before, I know a lot of people were complaining about this, and I have discovered that there is one slight problem if you are using a subproject with a Google Calendar synchronization. Yeah, sure, that's the only one so far that I found doesn't work as it would have worked with subprojects, you can open and close these, and I can focus in on just this week's daily routines, and you can open them up. And it works pretty much the same way as subprojects worked before. Just wanted to point that one out because I did see that Twitter storm. Everyone's so upset about it when really you're this maybe not really worth getting upset. So there we go, we have the so using sections there, and then your next 3 days here again, that's a really simple filter. You're probably getting the idea now. So for the filter query here is 3 days, so he's going to show me all the tasks that I have for the next 3 days. Another one that find for those of you who like to use dates for everything, you can actually create a filter that shows anything that doesn't have any date. So as you can see here, none of these tasks in here have a date. And that's very useful if you like to make sure that everything's dated. So I would use that one in my... So for example, let's go into edit this filter. I'm going to do this live, so this might not work. And I'm going to put p:... this week, and let's just see if this works. It might not work. No tasks in this filter. That's because I am very good, and I've got all my tasks, as you can see here, have all got dates. Everything in here has got a date. But that's another one that you could use, no date. And I really like the idea of that one, because when I do my weekly planning session, I do like to make sure that my this week folder, every task has a date, so I can actually use no date and p project means project this week. So it will give me anything that I haven't dated can come up there, and from that filter I can date any remaining tasks. So there's a good one for you. Older than 6 months. Now this one is an interesting one. You can do older than 12 months. The filter for this is created before, and then minus 178. That's how many days it takes to do 6 months. 365 days if you wanted to create this for a year. Now, somebody pointed out that because routines very rarely change, what you will find is a lot of tasks will come up from your routines. So you can remove those by going minus 178 days and not P routines, because routines will come up. And also you may all want to add in not recurring areas of focus, because over time your recurring areas of focus will be older than 6 months. Now the reason I've created this filter is very useful is any task that you have that is older than 6 months, you need to be asking the question, why has this not been completed? It shouldn't be there, and it should have moved within 6 months. So that's why this filter is a really good one to have for when you're doing a weekly planning session. You can check that all your tasks are being completed, and if they're not, you can ask the question why. Another one which you may want to use, but I don't know why, but I know that this could be useful for some, view all. This is just a view. Oh, sorry, if going to this one, older than 6 months. Oh, I showed you that. View all, quite a simple filter really, is just view all, and then you've got filter query is view all. If for whatever reason, and I cannot think of one, you may want to see every single task that you have open in your Todoist that's not been completed. You may want to see that. I don't know. Now, this is just my demo account, but if I was using my regular account, that'd be hundreds of tasks, and it wouldn't be organized by date. It would look horrible and blech. Now, wait, quick tip there. If you hit the D key, it's not going to work. I thought if you hit the D key, you might be able, but I just remembered in filters, that doesn't work. So, unfortunately, this is organized by priority, which is okay. Next one up is morning task, which I've spelled incorrectly. So I'm just going to go into here. I'm going to edit this filter. I'm going to just change my spelling because that's going to annoy the hell out of me. So my morning tasks here. So for my morning task, this is anything that's flagged orange that I want. I use the flags in the system where orange flags, that's P2, are for my morning tasks, and blue tasks are my afternoon tasks. So if I have a particularly busy day, I can really zoom in on the tasks that I've decided I'm going to complete in the morning. And then I can do the next one, which is for blue tasks, afternoon tasks. And the filters for that is, again, very, very simple. It's today and P2, and you've got the next one is today and P3. So there you go. There's just some tasks that I've played around with. I think can be really useful or not, in the case maybe no date, but these can be really useful to you, and just to give you some ideas of the kind of filters that you can create. And it really want to get yourself to become a little bit creative with this and to come up with different ways of creating filters. What you really want to do is to use filters to reduce stress and overwhelm and to focus you in on what is important. Well, there you go. Hopefully you found this useful. Thank you very much for watching this episode. And it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.